Although new HIV infections and AIDS cases continue to decline across the United States, the Bronx is still home to 25,000 people living with HIV. And to tackle this issue, Montefiore Health System and Albert Einstein College of Medicine have been awarded a three-year $975,000 grant that will enable real-time communications between patients and providers through a secure text messaging and video platform. Joining us to tell us more, we welcome Medical Director at Montefiore AIDS Center, Dr. Barry S. Zingman. Hello, doctor. Welcome.
Hi there. Hi. Thanks for having me.
Well, thank you for being here with us, and congratulations on this wonderful grant that I'm sure is going to assist many, many of individuals in the Bronx. Can we open up with just sharing our viewers, how the Oval Center at Montefiore is serving adolescents and adult patients?
Sure. Thanks for asking. So let me just give an introduction. The Montefiore AIDS Center is the largest HIV treatment program in New York State. We care for about 3,300 people living with HIV at two different clinics in the Bronx. At our second clinic is the Oval Center at Montefiore. It was created about 8 years ago as a way to better attract people newly infected with HIV as the epidemic has changed over time. So the HIV epidemic in the Bronx, when it first started, was primarily from heterosexual sex and from injection drug use. Particularly over the last 10 to 15 years, the epidemic here has changed. Right now, close to 80% of people newly infected with HIV, newly diagnosed with HIV, are LGBTQ. So sexual risk among LGBTQ individuals has become the primary risk factor. And so we created a second clinic at Montefiore in the Bronx to be able to better meet the needs of these folks. And so the Oval Center at Montefiore is that location. The Oval Center is based around sexual health care and LGBTQ care specifically. So the Oval Center is a really warm and welcoming and affirming environment for young people who are sexually active, young people who are LGBTQ positive. And it's affirming, like I mentioned. We have staff who are members of the community or strong allies of the community. It's open on a easy schedule, and it is non-judgmental. And there we offer services around sexually transmitted infections, HIV prevention care for people who need things like Truvada for PrEP. We also offer HIV care to young LGBTQ individuals, anywhere from ages 15 and up. And so we have a large population of young people who are getting services at the site. And in the last 3 years, we started offering HIV care to these same individuals. So that's kind of the setting. We offer contraceptive care, gynecologic care, trans-affirming hormonal care at the site. So it's really a very welcoming place.
It sounds welcoming. I think you covered everything. And you know, I think even myself, I'm curious to know, like, is HIV AIDS curable at this point?
So thanks for that. And there is some confusion over that. So HIV is an infection that stays in the body for the rest of your life. So, and there are other infections like that, that once you get them, they're with you the rest of your life. So HIV is one of those. There is no cure for HIV. However, the treatments that have been developed over the last 30 years now can completely control HIV. So they can control HIV to the extent that if there's been damage done, most of the damage gets reversed. We can now promise people a normal lifespan living with HIV if they get diagnosed early and start on treatment and stay on treatment. They can have a normal lifespan. And that is a dramatic change from even 15 years ago. So the prognosis is fantastic, but people need to get diagnosed, get in care, and stay in care. And that is a challenge, particularly for young LGBTQ individuals, particularly for people of color who are younger. These are very challenging. It is very challenging to get in care and stay in care. And so that's why we have this grant to try to support people.
Right. And which now leads us back to this welcoming environment that you basically introduced us to, and how now technology is going to also play a part in enrolling these individuals to really just make it their business to check their status. Right. And so let's talk about that component, the technology component, because we haven't even talked about Evolution, which is the program, right?
That's right. So let me just clarify that the grant program is called Evolution. It is based on a model that was created in St. Louis that has been shown to help young LGBTQ individuals of color living with HIV to control their HIV much better, to stay in care better, and to do much better. So we are the first site in New York City that is trying to replicate this and offer it to our patients. It's sponsored by the New York City Department of Health, and we're in some ways a test site for it in New York City. Can we make it work in New York City? Can we make it work with our population in the Bronx that really needs it? And it has two components. One is a text messaging and service, secure text messaging between the patient and our support staff, so that there is secure ability to tell us your concerns and for us to help support you if you have questions or having barriers or having problems filling your medicines or just don't know when your appointment is or are having a bad day or feeling depressed, having job issues. So we can actually support you directly through text messaging, which is a preferred method of communication, of course. In addition, the secure app that we're going to be able to have people use can push out information to people. So it can push out reminders and pep talks and tips to help them, to help support them on a daily basis. The second component, besides for the electronic one, is that it enables us to hire another social worker to be able to provide individual and group counseling and psychosocial support to young LGBTQ individuals of color living with HIV. So we are going to be able to give them not only electronic support, but also direct support from a trained social worker who's attuned to LGBTQ issues. So it's both components that are actually really key the counseling and the group support has been shown to be able to really, really help LGBTQ individuals to acquire some of the new coping skills that they may need to have or get to be able to live successfully with HIV.
Got it. And so before we go, is this a free service or is this an app that people upload? Is there a registration required? How does that work?
Yeah, thanks. So so it would be offered to people engaging in care at the Oval Center for their HIV care. So it helps to support the HIV medical care that you're getting from our doctors and nurse practitioners at the site. It's completely voluntary, and we would be offering it to everybody between the ages of 15 and 29 who's HIV positive and getting care with us. Completely voluntary. You actually sign a consent form saying that you recognize that text messages may call on your phone. We give you the app. We give you any training necessary. We introduce you to the staff, and it remains voluntary throughout. At any point, a person can choose and can say, you know, I'm good. I'm doing fine. I don't need this anymore. Or they can continue for up to the full 3 years. So we are offering it to at least 75 people over the 3 years. And we are really hoping that it's successful and that people really like it. And also we're not just pushing out a new program. We'll also be getting feedback from our patients in the program on how to help make it work better for them. as well. So that's also one of the interests of the Department of Health, is to see how we can make this work well, and then it can be spread to other clinics around the city.
Wonderful. I love the mindfulness being considered in the process, right? It's
right.
Really community-based, even though,
right.
Of course, there's the actual physical, the physician component and the diagnosis, as well as the care. So
let me just add, it's also available in English and Spanish. All the messaging, the educational content, English and Spanish.
Wonderful. Thank you for sharing that. And thank you for bringing it here to our viewers. Dr. Barry S. Zingman, Medical Director at AIDS Center at Montefiore Health Center and Health Systems, And for you guys, if you're interested in more information on evolution, you can call the Oval Center at 718-882-5482.